Welcome back, dear friends. I'm so excited for my new video. In this video I will talk about squirrels adaptation. Enjoy watching the video and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like this video, because this gives me great support to produce more videos about animals adaptation. What species is squirrel? A squirrel is a small mammal and is part of the Sciuridae family. They are also part of the scientific order Rodentia. These tree-scaling animals are medium-sized rodents in a family that also includes chipmunks, marmots, prairie dogs, flying squirrels, ground squirrels and tree squirrels. Squirrels are members of the Sciuridae family, which also contains small and medium-sized rodents. Tree squirrels, ground squirrels including chipmunks and prairie dogs and flying squirrels are all members of the squirrel family. Squirrels are native to the Americas, Eurasia, and Africa, and people brought them to Australia. Is a squirrel a rodent or a mouse? Squirrels are classified as mice for the following reasons. When you think of a squirrel, you might imagine a cute, bushy-tailed mammal hiding nuts in trees. In comparison, the word rodent conjures up images of filthy, invasive pests like mice and rats. What is the name of a female squirrel? Female squirrels, known as sows, can have 2 litters of young per year if food is plentiful and other variables are favorable. Litter size can range from 1 to 6 young, but is typically between 2 and 4. Can rodents consume meat? Yes, as previously stated, squirrels are omnivorous, so it is not uncommon to see them consuming meat. In the natural habitat, ground squirrels primarily ingest meat. Their food consists of small reptiles, lizards, mice, insects, and other creatures. What is the most unusual squirrel? Squirrels with albino gray fur. Albino gray squirrels are the most uncommon type of white squirrel. Mammalogists believe that the chances of a female gray squirrel having an albino child are 1 in 100,000. What exactly is an adaptation? An adaptation is anything that aids an animal's survival. Adaptations are classified into 2 kinds. Body components are examples of adaptations. Other adaptations are actions taken by the species. The oldest known fossilized squirrels come from the Eocene epoch, and squirrels are most closely related to the mountain beaver and the dormice among other living rodent families. Eastern gray squirrels have several sensory adaptations that help them thrive. They have a keen sense of smell, which aids them in finding sustenance. Their sense of smell is also used to identify other eastern gray squirrels' stress levels. What is the most common type of squirrel? Tree squirrels. Tree squirrels are the types most commonly recognized, often seen gracefully scampering and leaping from branch to branch. Other species are ground squirrels that live in burrow or tunnel systems, where some hibernate during the winter season. Flying squirrels have a patagium, a flap of skin between their front and back legs that enables them to glide from tree to tree. The underside of their tail is flat to aid in steering. These creatures also have big eyes that allow them to see in the dark. How does the fire-footed rope squirrel keep enemies at bay? One of the defensive strategies is to use an alarm call to alert the predator that the squirrel has been seen and to warn nearby squirrels of the impending danger. This is enough to deter some predators, such as cats, who prefer to attack when they are caught off guard. What are the top 5 traits of a squirrel? Squirrels have slender frames, very long, bushy tails, and big eyes. Their hair is soft and silky in general, though some species' fur is much thicker than others. Squirrel coat hue varies greatly between species and, in some cases, even within species. Body parts of a squirrel. Squirrels have powerful canines. Squirrels enjoy eating acorns. On the outside, nuts have a hard covering. Squirrels use their canines to crack open a nut's shell. Strong molars are a result of adaptation. Squirrel nails are very sharp. Squirrels use their sharp claws to scale trees. Sharp claws also aid squirrels in holding onto acorns while consuming. Sharp claws are a survival trait. What a squirrel does. Squirrels hide their nuts. When sustenance is scarce, squirrels dig up the nuts. Burying almonds for later consumption is an adaptation. Squirrels can scale branches. Squirrels get away from peril by climbing a tall tree. Climbing branches is a form of adaptation. When there is danger nearby, squirrels create noise. The noises warn other squirrels that peril is approaching. An adaptation is making noises to alert of danger. Squirrels have slender frames, very long, bushy tails, and big eyes. Their hair is soft and silky in general, though some species' fur is much thicker than others. Squirrel coat hue varies greatly between species and, in some cases, even within species. The following are stated purposes of squirrel tails to help the squirrel. To shield itself from weather, wind, or cold. When it gets heated, it cools down by pumping more blood through its tail. As a counterweight when jumping around in branches. When falling, use it as a parachute. To use as an indication. When tying flies, squirrel tail hairs are highly valued. When the squirrel sits upright, its tail folded up its back may stop predators looking from behind from seeing the characteristic shape of a small mammal. Red squirrels are one of the 81 tree squirrel species identified worldwide. Red squirrels, with their large eyes and long hind limbs suited for leaping, are well adapted to living in woodland habitats. Male and female are roughly the same height. Fur color varies greatly between animals, ranging from dark brown to light chestnut on the back and white to cream on the throat and breast. Red squirrels molt twice a year but only lose their distinctive ear tufts once. Tufts are frequently missing during the summer and are replaced in the late summer and fall. Habitat. Red squirrels spend the bulk of their lives in trees and feed primarily on the fruit of trees and plants, such as hazelnuts. The red squirrel prefers mixed broadleaf woodlands with a high species variety and abundant food. Despite the fact that Fermanagh has many suitable broadleaved woodlands, red squirrels are increasingly confined to coniferous plantations due to competition from the grey squirrel. These plantations are now basically the last refuge for red squirrel-only populations and are thus the focus of the FRSG's conservation goals and efforts. Diet. The red squirrel's diet consists mainly of tree and plant seeds and nuts. When they are plentiful in the fall and winter, these make up a significant portion of the diet. However, when the main food source is scarce in late spring and summer, the diet is supplemented with plant shoots and bulbs, insects, and berries. In years when seeds are scarce, fungi can be an essential food source. Squirrels get their water from the food they consume or from dew, though they have been observed drinking water from pools and streams during hot, dry summers. Red squirrels are scatter hoarders, which means they store seeds and other food items in various places. In the fall, they spend a lot of time caching food by burrowing holes just below the soil surface or in leaf litter. This stockpiled food is critical to get them through periods of harsh weather or when food is scarce. Drays. Dray is a red squirrel nest that can be discovered about two-thirds of the way up a tree at a fork between a branch and the main trunk. The dray is made of twigs that are carefully arranged to create a rounded nest about the size of a football, with moss and fur lining the inside. A dray differs from a bird's nest in that it is tightly connected to the trunk and only about two-thirds of the way up, and the twigs have the leaves still attached. A bird's nest, on the other hand, is located near the summit of the tree and further out on the branches, and the twigs are usually leafless. During the summer, red squirrels relax on open platforms made of twigs and softer material, or in sheltered, abandoned bird nests. Red squirrels frequently use more than one dray at the same time. Individuals have been recorded as using up to 8 drays per day, taking into account their rest and sleep periods. However, this number is quite high, with the average number used by an individual being 3. During the winter, red squirrels will sometimes live in drays together. Ecologists and researchers use the technique of counting the number of drays present in a specific area to estimate the number of squirrels present. Season of reproduction and life cycle. Squirrel breeding season begins in January with mating chases. In March, young squirrels known as kittens are born hairless, blind, and deaf. A second litter may be born in July-August if a female squirrel finds enough food to improve her condition. Each litter can have 3 to 4 kittens. After 10 weeks, the kittens are weaned and will disperse in the autumn or the following spring. Food availability has a significant impact on the survival of both adults and young red squirrels. Survival rates for juveniles surviving their first winter are estimated to be between 15 and 25%, with rates improving in subsequent years. A red squirrel has a life expectancy of 3 to 4 years, although they can live as long as 6 or 7 years. Red squirrels are preyed upon by a variety of predators, including the domestic cat, pine martens, foxes, and stoats. Red squirrels can be eaten by large raptors such as goshawks. However, none of these species play a significant role in the red squirrel population's continued decline. Squirrels do have a home range, but the size of it varies depending on the habitat type and thus food availability, as well as the season. Both the male and female are not territorial, and their ranges will overlap, as will the ranges of other males and females. During the breeding season, older females may exclude other individuals from their nest area, according to some research. The range sizes for deciduous woodland have been estimated to be between 2.8 and 6.8 hectares, 7 to 16.8 acres, and between 7 and 23 hectares, 17.2 to 56.8 acres for conifer forests. Summer ranges are also typically larger than winter ranges. Ten nutty facts to make you appreciate squirrels. Why is National Squirrel Appreciation Day, January 21st, so popular? Maybe it's because squirrels are adorable and entertaining to watch. Perhaps it's the numerous hats they wear, not real hats. Please don't put hats on squirrels. They play a variety of roles, including acrobat, bandit, gardener, trickster, and many others. I set out to discover why these creatures deserve their own day, and after reading the facts I discovered, you might just appreciate squirrels a little more. 1. Squirrels can find food buried beneath a foot of snow. Food is essential for squirrels during the cold winter months. It stands to reason that some species can detect food beneath a foot of snow. The squirrel will then dig a tunnel under the snow, following the scent to the or another squirrel's buried treasure. 2. The front teeth of a squirrel never stop growing. This is a common trait in other rodents as well. The term rodent comes from the Latin word rodere, which means to gnaw. 3. Thieves may steal up to 25% of squirrels' buried food. And that's just from their own species. Scatter hoarders, squirrels with multiple food caches, struggle to keep track of all of their hidden food. Fellow squirrels or birds frequently take advantage of this opportunity for a free meal. 4. To avoid predators, they zigzag. Squirrels flee in a zigzag pattern when they are threatened. This is a fantastic strategy for avoiding hawks and other predators. Unfortunately, it does not work well on automobiles. Consider slowing down, giving squirrels a break. 5. Squirrels may pretend to bury a nut to deter would-be thieves. Squirrels have been observed deceptively caching. A squirrel digs a hole and then vigorously covers it up, but without depositing the nut. This appears to be done to deter potential food thieves. 6. A newborn squirrel is approximately 1 inch long. If you come across one of these tiny baby squirrels, please consult these resources for information on what to do. This will increase the baby squirrel's chances of survival. 7. Squirrels were introduced by humans into the majority of our major city parks. The story of why there are so many squirrels in parks in the United States is truly fascinating and well worth reading. Squirrels are acrobatic, intelligent, and adaptable creatures. If you're still not convinced, try hanging a bird feeder without being challenged by these bandits. 9. They become bulky in the winter to keep warm. One strategy squirrels use to stay warm during the cold winter months is to gain weight. 10. Squirrels do not excavate all of the buried nuts, resulting in more trees. They have unintentionally added thousands of trees to our country's forests. That, in my opinion, is a pretty good reason to appreciate squirrels. Thank you for watching my video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and like to this video.